In linear algebra, we often solve the matrix equation Ax equals B. For small matrices A, you can do this by hand using row reduction. In our applications, however, we often have very large matrices A. We then use the computer to solve Ax is B. The matrices A, however, become so large that it is important to do this efficiently. One of those efficient algorithms is the LU factorization of a matrix. We will see what it is and how it can be used to solve Ax is B in this video. So, what's the idea? We have an M times N matrix A, and we want to write A as a product, L times U, where L and U are matrices. Well, L is a square matrix of size M times N, and it's a unit matrix, meaning N's on the diagonal, and a lower triangular matrix. Whereas U is an M times N matrix, and it is an echelon matrix of A. So, how does that look like? For example, if we have this matrix A over here, we can write this A as L times U. L and U are already given here. We will learn later how to find them. We can write A as L times U, where L is over here, so it's unit, and our triangular, so we have zeros above the diagonal, and U is an echelon matrix. As you see, the pivots are over here, so U is an echelon form, not a reduced echelon form. And now we can compute L times U. So if we check, compute L times U, see whether we get A. So L and U, use for example the row column rule, like this. So 1, 0 inner product with 1, 0 gives you a 1, correct. And then the 2, 1 inner product with 1, 0 gives you a 2, correct. And then we continue with the next column. 1, 0 inner product minus 1, 0 gives you a minus 1. 2, 1 inner product with minus 1, 0 gives you a minus 2, and so on. And you see, indeed, if you compute L times U, you get indeed A. So, question, how to find L and U for a given A? We'll do that later. First, we will see how we can use this decomposition to solve a linear system. So, we want to solve Ax equals B, and we know A equals L times U. So, that means that we want to solve L times U times X equals B. Now I can put brackets like this and define a new variable y as ux equals y. So we don't know x and we don't know y. But then the trick is as follows. Then over here we have ly equals b. Then we first are going to solve ly equals b. And then we have y. And then in the second step we are going to solve ux equals y. And that gives us our factor x. And now those two separate steps are very easy due to the special forms of L and U, as you will see in this explicit example over here. So we want to solve Ax equals B with this matrix A from the first example. We just continue with some factor B, minus 1, 4. Now how does it work? First we solve Ly equals B. So here's your L and here's your Y and there's your B. And due to your lower triangular form, we can immediately compute first the y1, 1 times y1 equals minus 1, so y1 equals minus 1, and then 2y1 plus 1, y2 equals 6, equals 4, so y2 equals 6, so you can immediately write down what your y is, and then in your next step, you want to solve ux equals y, but u is already in echelon form, so that's easy as well. You have your u, form the augmented matrix is y, you see that your x2 is free, doesn't have a pivot. You solve for x3, 3 times x3 equals 6, so x3 equals 2. And you can express x1 in terms of your free variable x2. x1 equals x2 minus 5. So once you have your LU composition for A, then solving Ax equals B can be done really fast.